Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon A. And in this lesson, we'll see actually the verbs that will be constructed with que, les verbes avec que, and the question is, shall we put indicatif or subjonctif after? Okay, so it's the first part, it means that we've got two parts for these verbs. Okay, so let's start right now. Accepter que. And then you will put subjonctif after. And this is the meaning. Admettre que. Indicatif. Affirmer que. Indicatif. Aimer que. Subjonctif. Ajouter que. Indicatif. Annoncer que. Indicatif. Apprendre que. Indicatif. Approuver que, subjonctif. Assurer que, indicatif. Attendre que, subjonctif. Avertir que, indicatif. Avouer que. Indicatif. Cacher que. Indicatif. Comprendre que. Indicatif. Confirmer que. Indicatif. Consentir à ce que. Subjonctif. Convaincre que. Indicatif. Convenir que. Indicatif. Craindre que. Subjonctif. Croire que. Indicatif. Décider que. Indicatif. Déclarer que. Indicatif. Découvrir que. Indicatif. Déduire que. Indicatif. Demander que. Subjonctif. Déplorer que. Subjonctif. Désirer que. Subjonctif. Détester que. Subjonctif. Dire que. Indicatif. And that's it for this video. Then keep in mind that the next video will cover exactly the same topic, but that the list of verbs will continue. I hope it was useful. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon B. And in this lesson, we'll continue, so it's the second part of the videos regarding this les verbes avec que, okay? Just to know that, well, if they should be followed by l'indicatif or then le subjonctif, okay? So it's the second part, and then there will be another one right after, okay? So three videos covering the same topic. Okay, so the list continues and we start right now. Douter que. Subjonctif. Dissimuler que. Indicatif. Écrire que. Indicatif. Empêcher que, subjonctif. Enseigner que, indicatif. Entendre dire que, indicatif. Entendre que, indicatif. Entendre que, subjonctif. And you can see that, of course, it's the same verb, it's entendre que, but then clearly the meaning is different. So that's when you will know whether you should put indicatif or subjonctif after your verb. So according to the meaning, okay? Espérer que, indicatif. Estimer que, indicatif. Être habitué à ce que, subjonctif. Éviter que, subjonctif. Exiger que, subjonctif. Expliquer que, indicatif. Garantir que, indicatif. Ignorer que, subjonctif. Imaginez que, indicatif. Indiquez que, indicatif. Informez que, indicatif. Interdire que, subjonctif. Jurer que, indicatif. Lire que, indicatif. Mériter que, subjonctif. Montrer que, indicatif. Nécessité que, subjonctif. Noter que, indicatif. Observer que, indicatif. Obtenir que, subjonctif. Ordonner que, subjonctif. Oublier que, indicatif. And that's it. So remember, the next video will cover the same topic and we'll finish with this list, this long list of verbs, okay? And that's it. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. Apprenez le français avec Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon C. And in this video, we'll finish this long list of verbs that are constructed with que. And then we can see together if they use indicatif or if they are followed by indicatif or then subjonctif. Okay, so it's the third part. So remember that if you want to see the full list, then, well, the previous video and the one before are covering the same topic. Okay, so let's start now. S'irriter, que, subjonctif. S'opposer à ce que, subjonctif. Savoir que, indicatif. Se douter que, indicatif. Se féliciter que, subjonctif. Se ficher que, subjonctif. Se froisser que, subjonctif. Se méfier que, subjonctif. Se moquer que, subjonctif. Se plaindre que, indicatif. Se rappeler que, subjonctif. Se réjouir que, subjonctif. Se rendre compte que, indicatif. Se soucier que, subjonctif. Se souvenir que, indicatif. Sentir que, indicatif. Signaler que, indicatif. Souhaiter que, subjonctif. Souligner que, indicatif. Soutenir que, indicatif. Supposer que, indicatif. Tenir à ce que, subjonctif. Tolérer que, subjonctif. Trouver que, indicatif. Veiller à ce que, subjonctif. Voir que, indicatif. Vouloir que, subjonctif. And that's it. So the list is over now. Okay, so I hope it was useful. Have a great day et à bientôt. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon D. And in this lesson, we'll see together les verbes pronominaux, and we'll actually try to see whether it's possible to see one form or two forms, okay? So, une forme ou deux formes. So, let's start now. And so, when we're talking about les verbes pronominaux, actually, we will have several situations. The first one will be that, actually, this verb will only exist at this form pronominal. So, it does mean that it won't exist at this other form, non pronominal. Okay, so we'll see that. The second situation is that, the two forms will exist, whether the pronominal and the non pronominal. And in these cases, well, actually, the meaning won't be that different. And the last situation, you will have the two forms existing, so pronominal and non-pronominal, but then the meanings will be quite different. Okay, so we'll start first with this situation when we've got only one form, la forme pronominale. Okay, so for example, we take this verb, se souvenir de, and it's quite interesting because, well, many students tend to make the mistake in a way when they want to use souvenir, well, they use souvenir without using this se. So actually they would like it to be non-pronominal, and unfortunately for you it doesn't exist. So actually souvenir like that doesn't exist, and if you want to use this verb, you've got to use it with se, so it will be la forme pronominale. Okay? Few examples like s'absenter, s'écrouler, s'effondrer, se moquer, se méfier, s'enfuir, s'en aller. Okay? So in all these cases, actually these verbs exist only with se before them, so pour la forme pronominale. Okay, so let's see now the meanings. S'absenter, s'écrouler, s'effondrer, se moquer, se méfier, s'enfuir, s'en aller. Okay, so you've got here the translations, and keep in mind that if you want to use them, you will have to use them with se, and then of course it will modify the way that you conjugate them. We've been seeing that previously, so you can check the previous videos about that. Okay? S'abstenir, s'efforcer de, s'envoler, se soucier, se souvenir, and that's it. Okay, so s'abstenir, s'efforcer de, s'envoler, se soucier, se souvenir. Okay, so it will be exactly the same situation. These verbs only exist, or they are only used as verbes pronominaux, so with this se before them, and they don't exist without it. Okay, so let's see now the second situation. So, deux formes, so they exist with or without se, so pronominal et non-pronominal, and then the meaning is not really different. Let's take this example, so the verb attendre, okay, and then the verb s'attendre à. So, s'attendre à means to expect, yes, and then attendre is to wait. So, clearly, you can see that the meaning doesn't change that much. Le sens change peu. And then la préposition peut changer, because you can see here that, of course, we've got the preposition à, okay? And we don't really have it right here, okay? S'attendre à, an example. Je m'attends à recevoir un appel. So it's actually, and then j'attends le train de 15h. Okay, so in that case, well, it will mean to expect. And then in that case, it will mean to wait. Okay, je m'attends à recevoir un appel. So I expect to receive a call. And then j'attends le train de 15h. Well, I expect the train that will arrive at 15h. Okay, so let's check now. S'attendre à, and then attendre, another one. Je m'attends à une belle surprise. Oh, then it would be possible also to use attendre like that. J'attends d'avoir une belle surprise. So it would be possible to express almost the same idea without using this forme pronominale. Okay. That's it. So now, if you want to use, well, some verbs, sorry, some verbs will have two forms, as I said, so the two forms will exist, but then strangely, the meaning will change, and actually, these two verbs will look alike, but then the meaning will be really, really different. Well, an example like s'apercevoir and apercevoir here, okay? So s'apercevoir will mean to notice, and then apercevoir, to catch sight of. Okay, so le sens change totalement, so the meaning changes quite much. Okay, and then la préposition peut changer, not in that case, but then, well, preposition might change when you put that whether at the form pronominal or non pronominal. Okay, so we'll see a few verbs now. Agir, s'agir de. Aller, s'en aller. Apercevoir, s'apercevoir de. Attendre, s'attendre à. Douter, se douter de. Ennuyer, s'ennuyer. Entendre, s'entendre avec. Okay, so let's see now the translations. Agir, s'agir de. Okay, so I will respect exactly the same order for the translations. Okay, so it will be agir, it's to act, and then s'agir de, to be about. Okay, so it will be exactly the same for the other verbs. Aller, s'en aller. Apercevoir, s'apercevoir de. Attendre, s'attendre à. Douter, se douter de. Ennuyer, s'ennuyer. Entendre, s'entendre avec. Faire, se faire à. Imaginer, s'imaginer. Mettre, se mettre à. Passer, se passer de. Plaindre, se plaindre de. Plaire, se plaire à. Prendre, s'y prendre. Let's see now the translations. Faire, se faire à. Imaginer, s'imaginer. Mettre, se mettre à. Passer, se passer de. Plaindre, se plaindre de. Plaire, se plaire à. Prendre, s'y prendre. Servir, se servir. Tromper, se tromper. Trouver, se trouver. And that's it. Servir, se servir. Tromper, se tromper. Trouver, se trouver. Okay? So remember that, well, we can have an example here now. S'apercevoir de, and then apercevoir. Je m'aperçois de mon erreur. And then j'aperçois un bateau sur la mer. Okay, so in these two cases, actually, the first one, s'apercevoir, will actually be translated by to notice. Okay, and then here, j'aperçois un bateau sur la mer, to catch sight of. Okay, so as you can see, well, of course, they look the same because you get apercevoir and s'apercevoir, but then the meaning is really, really different. Okay? So keep in mind that it's possible when we talk about les verbes pronominaux to have only one form, or then to have two forms, okay, pronominal and non-pronominal, and then the meaning will be almost the same, okay? And then it's also possible to have these two forms with totally different meanings when it comes to the form pronominal and non-pronominal. Okay, I hope it was clear. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon E. And in this lesson, we'll work together on les verbes pronominaux and more precisely, les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. Okay, so les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. Okay, so we'll see in the coming videos other type of verbs, les verbes pronominaux. Okay, but this one will focus on les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. And we can start right now. So what are les verbes pronominaux réfléchis? And it's a good question. So let's imagine that we've got the subject. So the subject will be me. And well, the idea of this verbe pronominaux réfléchi is that if I do something, so I will do une action, well, I will do it on myself, okay? And that's the whole concept of these verbes pronominaux réfléchis, okay? So I'm doing something and I'm doing something on myself, okay? So let's see now a few examples of verbes pronominaux réfléchis. The first one, se laver. Se lever. Se peigner. Se parfumer. Se raser, se maquiller. Okay, so all these verbs are in these categories, a category of les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. So let's see now what they mean, and now it will be probably more clear for you. So se laver is here, se lever, se peigner, se parfumer, se raser, se maquiller. Okay, so you can see that in all these cases, actually, when we're talking about, well, the verbs, well, if I say je me lave, well, clearly I am washing myself. Okay, so that's the whole concept. So the subject is doing an action on itself. Okay, so let's see now another series of verbs. S'amuser. Se brosser les dents, se coucher, s'habiller, se déshabiller, se regarder. Okay, so let's see now the meanings, the translations. S'amuser, se brosser les dents, se coucher, s'habiller, se déshabiller, se regarder. Okay, so now that you have an idea of what these verbes pronominaux réfléchis are, let's see how we will conjugate them, and we'll start with the present form. Je me lave. Tu te laves, il, elle se lave, nous nous lavons, vous vous lavez, il, elle se lave. Okay, so you can see that, well, actually, laver or se laver in that case is a regular verb, it belongs to the first group, so you've got the normal endings that we have for the present form, okay? And keep in mind that as it's a verb pronominal, as we say, you will have to add this thing for je, so je me lave, okay? Just to express that you are doing the action on yourself, je me lave, then tu te laves, il se lave, and then elle se lave, okay? Then nous, nous lavons, vous, vous lavez, il, elle se lave. Okay, so it's actually, it's not that difficult. You should just definitely remember that you should put these little things, you know, here, 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 and here. So let's see now for the passé composé form. Je me suis lavé. Tu t'es lavé, Il, elle s'est lavé. Nous nous sommes lavés. Vous vous êtes lavé. Ils se sont lavés. Elles se sont lavées. Okay. So what we can see here is that, well, you've got your subject, then you put me here, and then remember that because we are talking about un verbe pronominal, we should use at the passé composé form être and not avoir. And as we use être, then we should put at the end the feminine if needed. Okay, so that's the reason why it's like that. So, je me suis lavé. And then, if it would be the feminine form, then you should add this e at the end, but then phonetically it doesn't exist, you don't pronounce it, so it would be exactly the same form phonetically, je me suis lavé. Okay, same thing here, tu t'es lavé. Again, the feminine here, possible as well. Il s'est lavé, so if you use this il, of course you should keep the masculine form, and then if you've got elle, which is the feminine, you should put this at the end. Elle s'est lavé. Okay, here there is a little mistake, sorry. I didn't put as an option, but it could be here as well and here as well, okay? Because nous could be a group of women, and in that case you should put the feminine form, of course. Nous nous sommes lavés. So remember, final S is not pronounced. Vous vous êtes lavé. Okay, and then ils se sont lavés. Elles se sont lavées. So exactly the same thing. You put this E as an option. So if you've got il, you don't put it. And if you've got elle, so the feminine plural form, you should put it here. Keep in mind that when we're talking about the pronunciation, whether it's the masculine singular form like that, so it's lavé. If you've got the feminine form, it will be lavé as well. If you've got the plural form, it's lavé. And then if you get the plural and the feminine or feminine plural, it's lavé. So clearly, phonetically, you've got only one form and it's lavé. Okay? So it's quite important to remember if you want to write and if you don't want to make any mistakes to put the E at the end for the feminine form, and then to put the S for the plural form. But if you only want to speak French, then it's actually quite easy because you've got only one form, okay? And it's lavé. Important thing, it is possible to add what we call complément d'objet direct after the verb. Okay, so even if you've got this verbe pronominal réfléchi, so you are doing the action to yourself, it is possible to put un complément d'objet direct after the verb. Okay, so we'll see how it goes. For instance, if you've got the sentence Il se lave, okay, it is possible to use Il se lave, and then you want to be more precise because you want to say what parts of his body he's washing, okay? And in that case, you put les mains, hands. Il se lave les mains. Okay, so that's possible, okay? You could say il se lave, but then in that case, you don't really know, you know, what part of his body is washing. And in that case, if you want to be more precise, il se lave les mains. Okay? Elle se lave. Elle se lave les mains, so it would be exactly the same way to proceed. Okay? But then be careful because we've got some common and classical mistakes that students tend to make. This is one thing that I've been seeing quite often. Elle se lave ses mains. Okay, so in many situations, students tend to put here, so instead of what we saw it was les mains, they want to put the possessive, so they want to put ses mains, okay? Which, I mean, it would be logical, I mean, why not, you know? But then unfortunately, the French grammar say that no, it's not possible, so keep in mind that if you want to use this structure and put this complément d'objet direct after your verb, you should put the article here. Les, okay, and don't use the possessive c'est. Okay, so you say elle se lave les mains, and you don't say Elle se lave ses mains as we have or as we had here before. Okay, so it will be exactly the same thing here when you say tu te laves tes cheveux. It's actually, well, it would be logical, but then unfortunately that's not the way it goes. You don't say that. You will say, as we saw, tu te laves les, so the article, and then cheveux. Okay, so remember, don't put the possessive here when you get this type of structure. Okay? So, same thing. Je me lave mes dents. Well, actually, it's not possible, but you will say je me lave les dents. Okay, so remember, no possessive. Another thing to remember if you want to put le passé composé. Il s'est lavé. And then, il s'est lavé les mains. Okay, so you will keep this structure. It's actually quite simple. Il s'est lavé. And then you put your complément d'objet direct after les mains. Elle s'est lavé. So in that case, if you look carefully, as we saw previously, you should put the feminine form here at the end. Okay, because you are using être. In that case, but then look, and that's the reason why you should be careful, elle s'est lavée, and then you don't put anything here, okay, so you take away your feminine form, and you've got your complément d'objet direct after, so elle s'est lavée les mains. This is quite tricky. Many, many persons tend to make the mistake and to put this feminine form here, or it could be the plural as well, but then in that case it's the feminine. So take it away, don't put anything, and keep your structure like that. Elle s'est lavé les mains. So for instance, in that case, you've got elles se sont lavées. So remember that, well, it's logical. We use être, and then we put the feminine form because it's the feminine, and we put the plural form because it's the plural. But remember this strange rule, but still it's a rule, so you need to follow it. It will go like that as well. So, elles se sont lavées, and then you drop the feminine, you drop the plural form, you just put your participe passé like that, okay? And you continue your sentence with your complément d'objet direct, les mains. Okay, so, elles se sont lavées les mains. As I said, phonetically, if you speak, it's not a problem because laver, you pronounce it like that, and laver, same pronunciation. So, we don't hear that. If you pronounce this form instead of this form, it's not a problem because we don't hear it. Okay, if you want to write correctly, keep in mind that you should drop the feminine and the plural in this type of structure when you've got le verbe pronominal réfléchi and le complément d'objet direct after. I hope it was not too difficult and useful. Have a great day, au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 17, Leçon F. And in this lesson, we'll see together les verbes pronominaux and more precisely, les verbes pronominaux réciproques. Okay, so we saw previously, or in the previous video, les verbes pronominaux réfléchis. And in this video, we'll see les verbes pronominaux réciproque. Okay, so let's start now. And well, the good question that we could ask is, what are les verbes pronominaux réciproques? So let's see. And the first thing that you should keep in mind is that you will need two persons. So la personne numéro un, and then la personne numéro deux. Okay, and the concept is that la personne numéro un will do something that will affect la personne numéro deux, and la personne numéro deux will do something that will affect la personne numéro un. Okay, and this is what we call les verbes pronominaux réciproques. Let's see an example. And One good example will be se parler. Okay? So when you've got the sentence or the subject and here the verbs il se parle, okay? In that case it's quite clear. They speak to each other, if you want to translate that directly. This is the concept. So they speak or they talk to each other. And this is exactly the main concept of les verbes pronominaux réciproques. So, la personne numéro 1 parle à la personne numéro 2. La personne numéro 2 parle à la personne numéro 1. So, this cycle, okay, will actually symbolize, in a way, this concept of les verbes pronominaux réciproques. Okay? So, as we have two persons, la personne numéro 1 et la personne numéro 2, it means that le sujet est au pluriel. Okay, so the subject will need to be at the plural form, of course. Like we have here, il se parle, if you look, the subject is il and it's the plural form. Be careful because in some cases, well, let's say that it will be difficult in some cases to really understand. So, utilisation et compréhension parfois difficile. So, I will give you a good example here. You've got this thing. Il s'admire, okay? S'admirer, it's to admire. So, il s'admire. So, of course, you get the plural form and then it's verb pronominal. So, probably you could think that it's a verb pronominal réciproque. In this example, but actually it is possible to have, of course, two persons, okay, because we've got the plural, but in this situation it would be also possible that the first and the second person, they admire only themselves, okay? So it's actually not, as we saw previously, you know, they admire each other, but it could mean in that sense, it could mean that they admire themselves. And in this case, well, this il s'admire would be considered as verbe pronominal réfléchi. Okay? But then, of course, the same sentence can mean, as we saw previously, this concept of verbe pronominal réciproque. So, la personne numéro 1 admire la personne numéro 2. And then la personne numéro 2 admire la personne numéro 1. And in that case, of course, the meaning would be a verbe pronominal réciproque. So they admire each other. Okay? So it is tricky in some cases. Normally, it doesn't come like that. So normally you've got a context. And normally you tend to understand quite fast and quite well if it is verbe pronominal réfléchi or verbe pronominal réciproque, okay? So, but if it comes just like that without anything before or anything after, well, it can be tricky because, as we saw, it can mean two different things, okay? Be careful when we make the passé composé form because, of course, as we are using être here, okay, we will have to put at the end, well, whether the feminine or the plural. So when you get ils se sont regardés, so in this case, you will have to add this final S at the end because it's the plural. And then if you get the feminine form, elles se sont regardées, then you will get E for the feminine and then S for the plural form. Remember that we don't pronounce them, so you will get phonetically regarder, and then here the same form, regarder. Okay, so you don't pronounce anything after your E, but still you should write them if you want to write correctly. Okay, so masculin pluriel, and then féminin pluriel. And this is it. I hope it was useful. We will continue a little bit in the next video with les verbes pronominaux. Okay? But then, have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. Apprenez le français avec Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon G. And in this lesson, we'll see together les verbes pronominaux and we'll continue. And this video, we'll see more precisely les verbes pronominaux à sens passif. Okay, so the first question is, of course, what are they or what does it mean? Well, the main concept that you've got to keep in mind is that when we talk about le passif in French, it's actually quite strict in a way. We just want to express the fact that le sujet ne fait pas l'action. So the subject doesn't do the action. Okay, so I know it can be quite tricky. That's the reason why I want to give you an example here. Ce grand classique s'appelle Les Enfants du Paradis. So in that case, we want to talk about a movie, Les Enfants du Paradis, and it's a classical movie, so ce grand classique. So let's have a look at your sentence. Here you can see the verb. Okay, you can see that before the verb, you've got this S apostrophe, so it does mean that it is a verb pronominal. Okay, and then here, just before, you've got the subject, ce grand classique. But if you take 1 minute to look at the sentence, ce grand classique s'appelle Les Enfants du Paradis, you can notice that actually the subject, ce grand classique, doesn't do the action, because it's not possible. I mean, the movie cannot call itself. And that's the whole concept of what we call le passif. Okay, and in that case, this verb pronominal s'appeler will be used, as we saw here, un sens passif. Okay, so if we take a look again at the sentence, ce grand classique s'appelle Les Enfants du Paradis. Well, it could be possible to write it like that. Ce grand classique est appelé Les Enfants du Paradis. And this is one interesting thing, because now you notice that it is possible to use this verb appeler. So in that case, you don't have this form pronominal, okay? You just have this form non pronominal, so appeler. And it's possible to use it at the passive form. Est appelé, is called. Okay, so it would be possible in that case, and the good thing is that, well, in this situation, you notice that s'appeler and then appeler, so you can use this verb pronominal s'appeler instead of using the passive form est appelé. Okay, so it can be quite useful in some cases. So, ce grand classique est appelé Les Enfants du Paradis, so it would be an option, of course, or then it would be possible to use on appelle ce grand classique Les Enfants du Paradis. Okay, and in this situation, you notice quite well that ce grand classique, well, actually is not doing the action. Okay, so s'appeler, in that case, at the present form, can be used instead of a passive form, which is quite useful in a way, and it's quite good to remember that it's an option that you have instead of using le passif in some cases, of course, not all the time. So let's see few verbs that will be possible and will actually work as we saw with the s'appeler. So the first one is s'acheter, okay, and what I will give you the translation, but I will only give you the by translation, so the translation for acheter, just for a good reason. If you look at the sentence, les médicaments s'achètent dans les pharmacies, well, it's exactly the same thing. You want to say that les gens achètent des médicaments, dans les pharmacies. And so the interesting thing is to know the meaning of acheter. Okay, because this is what we will have to use. So, les gens achètent les médicaments dans les pharmacies. Les médicaments s'achètent dans les pharmacies. So, s'acheter, s'appeler, s'apprendre, se comprendre, se concevoir, se construire. Let's see now the translations. S'acheter, s'appeler, s'apprendre, se comprendre, se concevoir, se construire. Okay, so all these verbs can be used as well as we saw as verbes pronominaux à sens passif. The list continues. Se corriger, se couper, se dire, se diviser, s'employer, s'entendre. Se corriger, se couper, se dire, se diviser, s'employer, s'entendre. S'exprimer, se faire, se former, se lire, se nommer, s'obtenir. S'exprimer, se faire, se former, se lire, se nommer, s'obtenir. Se parler, se perdre, se porter, se pratiquer, se réaliser, se remarquer. Se parler, se perdre, se porter, se pratiquer, se réaliser, se remarquer. Se remplacer, se vendre, se voir, and that's it. Se remplacer, se vendre, se voir. Okay, so remember that all the verbs that we've been or have been presenting in this video, they can work as verbes pronominaux à sens passif. Okay, I hope it was clear. Have a great day and hope to see you soon. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 17, leçon H. And in this lesson, we'll see together se faire plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, so we can start right now. And I thought it might be useful to take a simple and short example. So this is the little sentence that we've got. Il se fait coiffer. Okay, so il se fait coiffer. And the thing is that, of course, we can spot here the verb se faire. Okay, so verb pronominal. And this is the infinitive, se faire. And the second verb that we have here is coiffer. And in English, it means to do somebody's hair. And if you take the time to look at the sentence, then it doesn't really make any sense, when you've got il se fait coiffer, because it would be strange that, well, il would do the action. Okay? And the clue is that se faire est une façon d'exprimer le passif. So we can use se faire as a way to express the passive form. And in that case, it makes more sense because you just realize that il, in that case, doesn't do the action at all. So you could change it and you could put it like that. Il est coiffé par, okay, or then quelqu'un le coiffe. So, it's actually quite interesting because it's a common way of expressing the passive form, okay? And it's quite, well, people use it quite often in French, okay? So, it's quite useful to know it, okay? So, il se fait coiffer actually will mean il est coiffé par, and then you can put the name of the person who is doing his hair, or then quelqu'un le coiffe, okay? So, let's see now how it would work if you want to, conjugate that. Je me fais inviter, tu te fais arrêter, Il, elle, se fait accompagner. Nous nous faisons insulter. Vous vous faites escorter. Ils se font appeler. Okay, so it would be the way to conjugate that. Okay, so me fait, te fait, se fait, nous faisons, vous faites, se font. Okay, and then after that, of course, you put the verb at the infinitive form. Okay, and then basically, this is the meaning. Je me fais inviter, so to be invited. Tu te fais arrêter. Elle se fait accompagner. Nous nous faisons insulter. Vous vous faites escorter. Ils se font appeler. Okay? So it's quite useful and it's not that difficult to construct. You just need to remember how to conjugate se faire at the present form in that case. And then you put the verb at the infinitive form. Okay? Be careful if you want to use se faire and then this structure at the passé composé form, then we'll see how it goes. So first we'll start with les formes au masculin. Okay, so what's masculine forms. Je me suis fait inviter. Tu t'es fait inviter. Il s'est fait inviter. Nous nous sommes fait inviter. Vous vous êtes fait inviter. Ils se sont fait inviter. And if you take the time to look at it, probably you can find something a bit strange. Because remember that normally when you use être with these structures, you normally have to put something at the end of your participe passé. So if it's like here, the plural form, normally we should have S here and here. And also here. But that's the rule. When we will use this structure, you don't put any plural form at the end. Okay? Nous nous sommes fait inviter, so it will be like that without S. Okay? So clearly you don't pronounce it when you speak, but then, so you don't really hear the difference. But if you write and if you want to write correctly, remember not to put any S at the end, even if it's the plural form. Okay? So it will be more clear when we will see now les formes au féminin, so for the feminine forms. So je me suis fait inviter, tu t'es fait inviter, elle s'est fait inviter, nous nous sommes fait inviter. Vous vous êtes fait inviter, elles se sont fait inviter. And in that case, you can see quite clearly that, well, first here, as we decide that all these forms should be for the feminine, it would mean that normally we should put this "e" at the end. But then in this case, we don't put any final "e", okay? And then exactly the same rule, we won't put any final "s" for the plural form. Okay, so that's the rule. Remember that even if we use être, we don't put for the participe passé form, we don't put any mark for the feminine and the plural form. Okay, and that's it. I hope it was clear and helpful. À bientôt. Have a great day. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent and this is Unité 17, leçon I. And in this lesson, we'll see together se laisser plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, so se laisser plus verbe à l'infinitif. And actually, I wanted to take a little and simple sentence here. Il se laisse coiffer. Okay, so il se laisse coiffer. And well, of course, you can spot se laisse here, and this is se laisser, so it's the infinitive. And the second verb that we've got in this sentence is coiffer, and in English, it's to do somebody's hair. Okay, so you've got this sentence, il se laisse coiffer, and it looks really strange because you've got the subject here, and then you've got the verb, and then coiffer, and then it means to do somebody's hair. And the clue here is that you can use se laisser actually as une façon d'exprimer le passif. So you can use se laisser as a way to express this passive form that we've got in French. And if you take this sentence, well, clearly, you could have it like that. Il accepte d'être coiffé par. And then it's quite clear now because it means that il, with this structure, se laisse, okay, doesn't do the action at all. Okay, so this is the concept of the passive. Remember, the subject doesn't do the action. Okay, so il se laisse coiffer. Okay, and the important thing here is this accepter. Okay, il accepte d'être coiffé. Why? Because se laisser, well, actually, if you want to translate that directly, you can translate it like to let yourself be, or then to let yourself become, or then to let yourself get. This let thing is quite important because we've got also this expression that we saw previously in the previous video, se faire, and then verb at the infinitive form, okay? And it's actually the same concept. You can express this passive form with se faire, okay? But in this case, when you use se faire, you want to give the idea that le sujet est partiellement responsable. So the subject has something to say in a way about what is happening. But when you use this structure, se laisser, and then the verb at the infinitive form, well, the difference between the two is that in this case, le sujet n'est pas responsable, ou résigner. So the subject let the things happen, actually. So the subject is not responsible, or then he is resigned. Okay? So this is the main difference between the two. Okay? Even if in both cases they are expressing this passive form, okay, there is this main difference between the two. Se faire, the person is partially responsible, or the person has something to say about what's happening. Je me laisse inviter. Tu te laisses arrêter. Elle se laisse accompagner. Nous nous laissons insulter. Vous vous laissez escorter. Il se laisse photographier. Je me laisse inviter. So you get the translation of the verb. Tu te laisses arrêter. Elle se laisse accompagner. Nous nous laissons insulter. Vous vous laissez escorter. Il se laisse photographier. So it's actually quite simple if you look at it. You get the verb se laisser. Okay, it's a regular verb, so for the endings it's not really tricky, especially at the present form here. Okay, so je and then me laisse, and after that you just put the verb at the infinitive. Okay, but of course we've got some tricky things, and when we talk about le passé composé, it will be a bit more difficult. Let's see how it goes. So we'll start with les formes au masculin. Okay, so the masculine. Je me suis laissé inviter. Tu t'es laissé inviter. Il s'est laissé inviter. Nous nous sommes laissés inviter. Vous vous êtes laissé inviter. Ils se sont laissés photographier. Oops, there's a different verb here. Well, it doesn't change anything anyway. So, je me suis laissé inviter. Tu t'es laissé inviter. Il s'est laissé inviter. Nous nous sommes laissés inviter. Vous vous êtes laissé inviter. Ils se sont laissés photographier. And the important thing, if you have a look at it, is that you don't have any S at the end of your participe passé form here, because normally when we've got a structure like that, and normally when we use être, the participe passé form that comes after should have at the end whether the mark of the feminine with e, but it's not the case because we started with the masculine form, or the mark of the plural s at the end. We don't pronounce it, but we should put it. And it's an exception here because with this type of structure, you don't put anything at the end of your participe passé. Okay? So it's quite a good news because it means that it will be always laissé like that. Even if you don't pronounce it, well, you know, in some cases when you need to put it, well, you need to put it. In that case, you don't need to put it, so it's a good news. And for the feminine form, je me le suis laissé inviter, tu t'es laissé inviter, elle s'est laissé inviter, nous nous sommes laissés inviter, vous vous êtes laissé inviter, elles se sont laissées photographier. So it's coming back, this strange one. But then it's exactly the same thing. So keep in mind that for your participe passé form here, so normally, you know, if we would respect the grammatical rules, we should, because we have être, we should put at the end of the participe passé here the mark of the feminine, e, and then here we should put e s at the end. So mark of the feminine, e, and then mark of the plural, s. But with this structure, you don't need to put the feminine or the plural, so it's a good news. It goes like, je me suis laissé inviter, like that. Whether it's the masculine or the feminine, you don't make any difference. And that's it. Merci beaucoup. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon J. And in this lesson, we'll see together se voir plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, so we can start right now. And so the sentence that we will start with is il se voit invité à une réception. Okay, and of course, the thing that will interest us is se voir, and of course it is the infinitive se voir. But then if you look at the sentence, so se voir would be to see oneself, okay? And it doesn't really make a sense if you look at the sentence like that. Il se voit invité à une réception. And the key is that you get to know that you can use se voir as a way to express the passive form. So, une façon d'exprimer le passif. Okay? And it's quite interesting because if you think about the passive form, then it means that the subject doesn't do the action. So, actually, in this case, il doesn't do the action, so invite, but it's the passive, so he is invited. Okay? So, you could actually have the sentence like that. Quelqu'un l'invite à une réception. Somebody is inviting him at a reception. Or then, if you want to directly translate the sentence, it would go like that. He sees himself invited to a reception, but then clearly you would translate it like that. He is invited to a reception. So it's a way to avoid the passive. If you don't want to say il est invité, he is invited, you can use il se voit invité à une réception. Okay? So let's see how we can conjugate that at the present. Je me vois invité, tu te vois invité, elle se voit invité, nous nous voyons invité, vous vous voyez invité, il se voit invité. Okay? So translation would be like that. Je me vois invité, tu te vois invité, elle se voit invité, nous nous voyons invité, vous vous voyez invité, il se voit invité. Okay, so it's not that difficult. Of course, you need to remember how to conjugate this voir verb at the present form in that case, because it's not a regular verb, so it's voit, 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 voyons, voyez, and then voit. Okay, and of course, as we are using this form pronominal here, se, so you should put me. Je me vois, tu te vois, elle se voit, nous nous voyons, vous vous voyez, il se voit. Okay, and after that, you just put your infinitive verb. Okay, of course, when we're talking about these structures, then they can be tricky at the passé composé form. And it is the case. So we'll start with the masculine Je me suis vu invité. Tu t'es vu invité. Il s'est vu invité. Nous nous sommes vus invités. Vous vous êtes vu invité. Ils se sont vus invités. And it's actually quite strange because if you take the time to look at the forms and especially the plural forms here, normally when we've got this type of structure, so we've got here se voir at the passé composé form, normally you should put s at the end here, here, and here. But that's the rule with this structure here. So when you use se voir followed by a verb à l'infinitif and you want to express this thing, then you don't put this final s at the end. Okay? And then for the feminine form, it will go like that. Je me suis vu invité. Tu t'es vu invité. Elle s'est vue invitée. Nous nous sommes vus invités. Vous vous êtes vus invités. Elles se sont vues invitées. And it's exactly the same thing as we had previously. So for the plural form, you don't put this final s, okay? But then we've got also, because it's the feminine, we don't put this final a here that you should put normally in a normal situation. Okay, so pas de E, pas de S à la fin. And that's it. Voilà, merci, au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent and this is Unité 17, leçon. And in this lesson, we'll see together the verb s'entendre followed by un verbe à l'infinitif. S'entendre plus verbe à l'infinitif. Oh my god, I was so fast. So I want to start. Let's start with this structure. Il s'entend appeler par son prénom. Okay, so let's take the time to have a look at this first part here. S'entend, and then of course it's s'entendre, so this is the infinitive form. So s'entendre, if you would like to translate it directly, it's to hear oneself, okay, or to listen to oneself, but then to hear oneself, and then actually it doesn't really make any sense if you start to, directly translate this sentence with this concept, hear oneself, it's quite strange. And the reason why is that you will use s'entendre as a way to express the passive form. Une façon d'exprimer le passif. Okay? And in that case, well, you understand that if it is the passive form, then it means that the subject doesn't do the action. So in that case, il won't call. I mean, he's not calling. Okay? But then if you want to get the meaning of the sentence, you could use this. Quelqu'un, somebody, someone is calling him by his first name. Okay? Quelqu'un l'appelle par son prénom. Okay? And this is the structure that you could use. So you could use s'entendre here. Okay? And then after that, you put the verb at the infinitive form. Il s'entend appeler par son prénom. Okay? So let's see now. How you will conjugate that at the present form. Je m'entends appeler. Tu t'entends appeler. Elle s'entend appeler. Nous nous entendons appeler. Vous vous entendez appeler. Ils s'entendent appeler. Okay, and remember, it's a way to express the passive form. Okay, so it's actually quite simple. You only need to remember the conjugation of entendre at the present form. Entend, entend, entend. Entendons, entendez, entendre. And then, as it's un verbe pronominal, okay, you will have to add this m for je m'entends, t for tu t'entends, s, elle s'entend, nous nous entendons, vous entendez, and then, ils, elles s'entendent. OK? Then it's followed by the verb at the infinitive. So it's actually quite simple to make. OK? Keep in mind that, as usual in French, we've got some tricky forms, and we're talking in that case about le passé composé. So we'll start with the masculine. OK? So je me suis entendu appeler. Tu t'es entendu appeler, il s'est entendu appeler, nous nous sommes entendus appeler, vous vous êtes entendu appeler, ils se sont entendus appeler. And the main thing that you've got to keep in mind is that you won't put this S at the end of your participe passé if you need to. Okay, because normally when we get this type of structures, normally we've got être and then the participe passé, we put être. S when we get the plural form. In these cases, or in these cases, when you use s'entendre and then a verb and the infinitive, you don't put this S at the end of your participe passé. If you've got a feminine form, then je me suis entendu appeler, tu t'es entendu appeler, elle s'est entendu appeler, nous nous sommes entendu appeler, vous vous êtes entendu appeler, elles se sont entendu appeler. And it will be exactly the same situation, so keep in mind that as it's the feminine, we'll have also this E at the end of our participe passé, but then we don't put that. So that's the rule. Don't put the feminine, okay, at the end of your participe passé here, and don't put the plural either here. Okay, so these are the only tricky things that you should keep in mind. And that's it. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir et à bientôt. Have a great day. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. Apprenez le français avec Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon L. And in this lesson, we'll see together le passé simple. So this video will be divided in two parts. The first one will be covering l'utilisation, so when do we use le passé simple. And the second one will cover la formation, so how do we construct this passé simple tense. So we can start right now with l'utilisation, okay? And, well, the main thing when we think about le passé simple, well, the first thing, it's a tense from the past, and then utiliser à l'écrit. So in most of the cases, you will see or you will encounter this passé simple form at a written form, okay? So dans la littérature, dans les récits historiques, dans les contes, dans les journaux. Okay, so in most of the cases we will see these passé simple forms in literature, dans la littérature, historical stories, les récits historiques, fairy tales, les contes, and then newspapers, les journaux. Okay, and then keep in mind that it is quite rare à l'oral, assez rare à l'oral. So, dans le passé, in the past, of course, and you will express with le passé simple, une action, un fait, un événement. Okay, so it will be used in the past to express une action, an action, un fait, a fact, and then un événement, an event. Keep in mind that you don't have any connection with the time when you say or when you tell this thing at the past, okay, so pas de connexion avec le moment de l'énonciation. And the last thing is that normally the person who will express this passé simple form will be somehow exterior to the story. So la personne est extérieure au récit. Okay, so keep that in mind if you want to express in the past une action, un fait, or then un événement, okay? Don't have any connection with the time when the person is telling this past form, okay? And then the person who is actually telling this past form is somehow exterior to the story. Okay, so this is now how we will construct la formation du passé simple. And you will see that it's a bit tricky, so I've been making some groups and then subgroups, but then here are the groups. So the first one is, well, the first group of regular verbs in French, you know, ending with er, okay? And for this group, well, the endings will be for je, ai, and then for tu, as, il, elle, a, nous, A, accent circonflexe, M-E-S. Vous, A, accent circonflexe, T-E-S. Il, elle, and the plural form, E, accent grave, R-E-N-T. Okay, so you've got here your endings for the first group of verbs, so the regular verbs, A-I, A-S, A. A accent circonflexe MES, A accent circonflexe TES, E accent grave RENT. Okay? And let's see now the endings for the group of the second, sorry, the verbs of the second group and the regular verbs in IR. Okay, so you will have for je, IS, and then for tu, IS, for il, elle, IT. Pour nous, I accent circonflexe M-E-S, vous, I accent circonflexe T-E-S, and then il, elle, at the plural form, I-R-E-N-T. Okay, so we get these. There are the endings for the verb, the regular verbs from the second group, I-R. Okay, so I-S, I-S, I-T, I-M-E-S, I-T-E-S, I-R, E-N-T. Okay, don't forget the circumflex here and here. So let's continue now. And we'll discover now, so it's a bit more tricky. So we're not talking about groups and subgroups, but we'll talk about the verbs that will have their participe passé, so past participles, in I en I. Okay, so remember, we're not talking about all the verbs in IR, for instance. And then je, so it will end with IS. Tu, it will end with IS. Il, elle, it will end with IT. Nous, I accent circonflexe MES. Vous, I accent circonflexe TES. Il, elle, IRENT. So of course you can tell me that, well, these endings are exactly the same as we saw previously. And yes, of course, because, well, all the regular verbs from the second group in IR do have their participe passé in I, like that, okay? But in this case, we're mostly talking about, and we'll see a few examples, about the verbs from the second group that do have their participe passé in I, okay? So let's continue now with these groups. So we're talking about the verbs ending with OIR, but then, of course, as usual, I'm honest with you, and we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them, okay? And the endings will go like je, us, tu, us, il, elle, ut, okay? Nous, u accent circonflexe, mes, vous, u accent circonflexe, tes, il, elle, urent. Okay, so keep in mind these endings, so US, US, UT, U accent circonflexe MES, U accent circonflexe TES, URENT. And we're talking about the verbs ending with OIR, but remember, not all the verbs. Let's see now another category, OIRE, and then as usual, remember, we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them. And the endings will go like je, US, tu, US, and then il, elle, UT, okay. Nous, U accent circonflexe, MES, vous, U accent circonflexe, TES, il, elle, U-R-E-N-T. Okay, so remember, verbs ending with O-I-R-E, but not all verbs. U-S, U-S, U-T, U accent circonflexe M-E-S, U accent circonflexe T-E-S, U-R-E-N-T. Okay, and we'll continue with the verbs that do have their participe passé en U. Okay, remember, not all the verbs, of course, but most of them. And the endings will be je, us, tu, us, il, elle, ut, nous, u accent circonflexe, mes, vous, u accent circonflexe, tes, il, elle, urent. Okay? And then verbs like tenir and venir, they are a bit tricky, so be careful, we're talking about these two verbs, but then, of course, all the composed verbs based on tenir and venir, okay? So let's see now. And then, je, I-N-S, tu, I-N-S, il, elle, I-N-T, nous, I-N-M-E-S, vous, I-N-T-E-S, il, elle, I-N-R-E-N-T. Okay? So, we'll now see a few examples. Quelques exemples. And now I will focus on the pronunciation. Okay? So, let's start with the first group. So, les verbes en ER. And then the example is parler. Okay? Je parlais. Tu parlas. Il parla. Elle parla. Nous parlâmes, vous parlâtes, ils parlèrent, elles parlèrent. Okay, so one more time. Je parlais, tu parlas, il parla, elle parla. Nous parlâmes, vous parlâtes, ils parlèrent, elles parlèrent. And now, the second group of verbs ending with ER, so the regular one, and I've been choosing this finir, to finish or to end. Example. Je finis, tu finis, il finit, elle finit, nous finîmes, vous finîtes, ils finirent, elles finirent. Okay, so one more time. Je finis, tu finis, il finit, elle finit, nous finîmes, vous finîtes, ils finirent, elles finirent. And now, let's see all the verbs that will have their participe passé en I. Remember, it was not all the verbs, so I've been choosing this suivre verb to follow. Je suivis, tu suivis, il suivit, elle suivit. Nous suivîmes, vous suivîtes, ils suivirent, elles suivirent. Okay, so one more time. Je suivis, tu suivis, il suivit, elle suivit, nous suivîmes, vous suivîtes, ils suivirent, elles suivirent. And now, let's see a few verbs. So, like, attendre, so it's to wait, dire, to say, entendre, to hear, faire, to do, mettre, to put, sorry, and then voir, to see. J'attendis. Tu dis, il entendit, elle entendit, nous fîmes, vous mîtes, ils virent, elles virent. Okay, so, j'attendis, tu dis, il entendit, elle entendit, nous fîmes, vous mîtes, ils virent, elles virent. Alright, so let's continue now with this group. Remember, verbs ending with O-I-R, but we said that it was not all the verbs, so I've been choosing this recevoir example, to receive, recevoir, and it goes like that. Je reçus, tu reçus, il reçut, elle reçut, nous reçûmes, vous reçûtes, ils reçurent, elles reçurent. Okay, so one more time. Je reçus, tu reçus, il reçut, elle reçut, nous reçûmes, vous reçûtes, ils reçurent, elles reçurent. And now the verbs ending with O-E-R-E, and remember I said it, we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them, and for this example, I've been taking boire. Boire is to drink. Je bu, tu bu, il bu, elle bu, nous bûmes, vous butes, ils burent, elles burent. Okay, so one more time. Je bu, tu bu, il bu, elle bu, nous bûmes, vous butes, ils burent, elles burent. And now the verbs that will have their participe passé en U. So I've been choosing this lire verb. So lire is to read. Je lus, tu lus, il lut, elle lut, nous lûmes, vous lûtes, ils lurent, elles lurent. Okay, so one more time. Je lus, tu lus, il lut, elle lut, nous lûmes, vous lûtes, ils lurent, elles lurent. And now, venir, venir is to come, so remember they were a bit tricky. So we're talking about venir and all the verbs that will be formed with venir. Je vins, tu vins, il vint, elle vint, nous vîmes. Remember, it's quite tricky to pronounce that. Vîmes. Vous vintes, ils vinrent, elles vinrent. Okay, so one more time. Je vins, tu vins, il vint, elle vint, nous vîmes, vous vintes, ils vinrent, elles vinrent. And then, as I said, tenir, so exactly the same thing as we had for venir, so we're talking about tenir and all the verbs that will be composed based on tenir, okay? So, je tins, tu tins, il tint, elle tint, nous tîmes, same thing, same tricky phonetical thing here, nous tîmes, okay? Vous tintes, il tinrent, elle tinrent. One more time, je tins, tu tins, il tint, elle tint, nous tîmes, vous tintes, ils tinrent, elles tinrent. And this is it for le passé simple. So I will do a few videos right after this one, and we'll see, well, of course, être and avoir, and a few other important verbs at the passé simple form. Okay? I hope it was useful. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 17, Leçon M. And we'll see in this lesson le passé simple, and more precisely, le passé simple du verbe être. Okay, so let's see now. Être au passé simple. Je fus. Tu fus. Il fut. Elle fut. Nous fûmes. Vous fûtes, ils furent, elles furent. Okay, so one more time, encore une fois. Je fus, okay, keep in mind that final S is not pronounced. Tu fus, exactly the same thing, final S not pronounced. Il fut, final T not pronounced. Elle fut. Okay, so basically you get only one phonetical form here, and it's fut, 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 the same. Okay, then, nous fûmes. Final S not pronounced. Vous fûtes. Same thing. Ils furent. Elles furent. Keep in mind that ENT, you know, the ending for the plural form is never pronounced, though. Furent. Okay? Ils furent. Elles furent. D'accord? Je fus. Tu fus. Il fut. Elle fut. Nous fûmes. Vous fûtes. Ils furent. Elles furent. And that's it. You've got the passé simple forms of the verb être, and être is to be. Voilà, j'espère que c'était utile. Au revoir et à bientôt. Have a great day. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 17, Leçon N. And in this lesson, we'll continue. We've been starting this series of videos covering le passé simple. And in this one, we will cover the verb avoir, so to have. Okay, so let's start now. Avoir au passé simple. J'eus, tu eus, il eut, elle eut. Nous eûmes, vous eûtes, ils eurent, elles eurent. Okay, so as you can see, phonetically it's quite a challenge because you've got to keep in mind that for each forms you will pronounce this combination of vowels e, u. You don't pronounce it like normally we would pronounce it e, okay, but we will pronounce it u all the time. Okay, so ju, final s not pronounced. Tu eus, final S not pronounced. Il eut, final T not pronounced. Elle eut. Then, nous eûmes, so you can make this little link between the two. Final S not pronounced. Vous eûtes, same thing here, and then the link. Vous eûtes. Ils eurent, elles eurent. Okay, remember that when we've got this ENT ending at the end of the plural form, so third person of the plural, you don't pronounce it, so you get ur, okay, and then with the link, the liaison, ils eurent, elles eurent. Okay, so one more time, j'eus, tu eus, il eut, elle eut, nous eûmes, vous eûtes, ils eurent, elles eurent. And that's it, you get all the forms of the passé simple for the verb avoir. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon O. And in this lesson, we'll continue the long series covering le passé simple. And in this case, we'll see le passé simple du verbe faire. So the verb to do. Okay, so let's start now. And so we've got faire, and it means to do, as I said. And this is the passé simple form. So let's start now. Je fis. Tu fis. Il fit. Elle fit. Nous fîmes. Vous fîtes. Ils firent. Elles firent. Okay, so one more time. Je fis. Final S not pronounced. Tu fis. Same thing. Il fit, elle fit. Final T not pronounced. Nous fîmes. Same thing here, you don't pronounce the S. Vous fîtes. Don't pronounce S. Ils firent, elles firent. Remember, ending ENT for the plural, you don't pronounce it. Firent. Ils firent, elles firent. Okay. Je fis. Tu fis. Il fit, elle fit. Nous fîmes. Vous fîtes, ils firent, elles firent. And that's it, you've got all the forms for the passé simple of the verb faire, to do. Have a great day, au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And this is Unité 17, Leçon P. And in this lesson, we'll see together le verbe aller, and more precisely, la forme du passé simple. And we can start right now. So let's see le verbe aller au passé simple. J'allais, tu allas, il alla, elle alla, nous allâmes, vous allâtes, ils allèrent, elles allèrent. Okay, so let's see that one more time. J'allais, tu allas, remember, final S is not pronounced. Il alla, elle alla. Okay, so you get the two forms here. You are pronouncing them the same way. You put this S for tu, but you don't pronounce it, okay? Then, nous allâmes, Okay, so remember that you should make this little link between the two. Nous allâmes, okay. Vous allâtes, same thing, la liaison. So final S here and final S here is not pronounced. Ils allèrent, liaison, elles allèrent. And then this ENT at the end, you know, the mark for the plural. Well, clearly you don't pronounce it, so you get allèrent. Okay, so ils allèrent, elles allèrent. So let's see one more time. J'allais, tu allas, il alla, elle alla, nous allâmes, vous allâtes, ils allèrent, elles allèrent. And that's it. You've got all the forms for le passé simple du verbe aller. I hope it was useful. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon Q. And in this lesson, we'll see the verb vivre. Vivre is to live, and we'll see especially le passé simple, so the forms from the passé simple du verbe vivre. Okay, so we can start right now. So we've got the verb vivre, to live, and then les formes du passé simple. Je vécu. Tu vécu, il vécu, elle vécu, nous vécûmes, vous vécûtes, ils vécurent, elles vécurent. Okay, so one more time. Je vécu, final S not pronounced, tu vécu, same thing. Il vécu, elle vécu, final T not pronounced. So basically you've got only one form here and it's vécu for all these three persons. Nous vécûmes, final S not pronounced, vous vécûtes, same thing here, ils vécurent, so remember, mark for the plural, ENT is not pronounced phonetically, you don't get it, so vécurent, okay, ils vécurent, and then elles vécurent. Okay, so one more time, je vécu, tu vécu, il vécu, elle vécu, nous vécûmes, vous vécûtes, ils vécurent. Elles vécurent. And that's it. You've got all the forms for le verbe vivre au passé simple. Voilà. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon R. And in this lesson, we'll see together le passé antérieur. Okay, so we can start right now. And normally, when I introduce tenses in videos, I divide the video in two parts. The first part will cover l'utilisation, so when do we use le passé antérieur, and the second part will cover la formation, how do we construct, how do we make this passé antérieur. Okay, so let's see first now l'utilisation. And well, the important thing when we talk about le passé antérieur is that we will use that pour exprimer des faits qui se sont passés avant d'autres faits passés. And then they should be exprimé au passé simple. So clearly, what does it mean? It means that this passé antérieur form is the past in the past. Okay, so when you want to express something that happened before another event that happened in the past, then in that case, you should use le passé antérieur, but keep in mind that it works in connection to le passé simple. So it means that if you want to use that orally, if you want to use this past in the past concept, normally we've got, well, the tense that I've been introducing previously, and that's what we call le plus que parfait. Okay? But then, in some cases, if you want to use le passé simple, and if you want to use something that happened before, then you should definitely use le passé antérieur. Okay, so keep in mind that l'utilisation est rare, so you will use it quite rarely, maybe never, okay, but you will probably encounter few passés antérieurs. L'utilisation est à l'écrit, So it's mostly written. And then l'utilisation est dans le langage soutenu. So we are talking about formal French in that case. We're not really talking about the French that you will use orally with friends or family, okay? Because in that case, you will use other tenses of the past. So let's imagine that this is now. So this is the present, c'est le présent, okay? And let's say that you want to express something that happened in the past and you want to use le passé simple, okay? So it's possible, of course. If you don't know how to make the passé simple, well, I've been making little videos on that, so you can check it if you want. Okay, so first idea, you want to express something in the past at le passé simple. So keep in mind that the rule is quite strict, because if you want to express something that previously happened, in that case, you get to use le passé antérieur. Okay, so first le présent, then first thing in the past, you want to use le passé simple. Keep in mind that this is le passé antérieur. That should be used if you want to express something that happened even before. Okay, so this is the past in the past. This is the concept. An example here. So, dès qu'il eut bu son café, il partit au travail. So, you can see here that you've got the verb boire, and it's at the passé antérieur form. So, first he decides to drink his coffee, then he decides to leave and to go to work. Okay, so in that case, you've got this passé simple here. So that's the whole concept. First you've got this passé antérieur, then you've got le passé simple. Everything happens in the past, okay, but then you wanted to use first, in that case, le passé simple, and then you've got no choice, but you've got to use le passé antérieur for this past in the past concept. So now let's see, how do we construct le passé antérieur? And I've been deciding to put few examples, okay? So the first sentence will be always at le passé simple, and the second sentence will be at le passé antérieur. So le passé simple, je mangeais au restaurant, okay? So the verb is manger, to eat, and then you will get j'eus mangé au restaurant. Second one, tu regardas la télévision. Regarder is to watch. Tu eus regardé la télévision. And then we've got il alla au travail. Il fut allé au travail. And if you take the time to look at these forms, you can spot and you can see that we've got two parts. So it means that it is a compound tense. Okay, and then as usual in French, when we're talking about compound tenses, then the second part here is always the same. It's le participe passé, so this past participle. Okay, so manger will become manger, regarder, regarder, aller will become aller. Okay, and the first part here, as usual in French, we will use whether avoir or être. And in this case, when we're talking about le passé antérieur, then avoir should be, or être should be, at the passé simple form. Okay, so this is the concept and this is the way we will construct this passé antérieur form. First you've got avoir, and it must be conjugated at the passé simple. Then you will put your participe passé, this past participle, and you will get le passé antérieur. Okay, in some cases, remember, we will use être. Same thing here, you get to conjugate être at the passé simple form, then you will get then you will put le participe passé and it will give you le passé antérieur. Let's see now the verbs that will require the use of être. And we're talking about aller, to go, arriver, to arrive, descendre, to go down, devenir, to become, entrer, to enter, to come in, monter, to go up, mourir, to die, naître, to be born, partir, to leave, rester, to stay, retourner, to return, to come back, sortir, to go out, tomber, to fall, and then venir to come. So all these verbs will be conjugated at le passé antérieur, and then more generally at all the compound tenses in French with être. And then we've got the verbs like se regarder, s'appeler, se présenter. Okay, so to watch, to look at oneself, to call oneself, to present oneself. So these verbs are called les verbes pronominaux. And all les verbes pronominaux will as well require être at le passé antérieur, or more generally at all the compound tenses in French. So let's see now how avoir is conjugated at le passé simple, because that's the first part that we will use in this passé antérieur form. And it's j'eu, tu eus, il, elle, on eut, nous eûmes, vous eûtes, ils eurent, elles eurent. Okay, so j'eu, tu eus, il eut, nous eûmes, vous eûtes, ils eurent. Then être goes like that. Je fus, tu fus, il fut, elle fut, on fut, nous fûmes, vous fûtes, ils furent, elles furent. Ok? Je fus, tu fus, il fut, nous fûmes, vous fûtes, elles furent. Ok? So this is the first part. Remember that you get to use when you construct this passé antérieur. Then the second part is what we call le participe passé. And keep in mind that when we're talking about the verbs from the first group, regular verbs ending with er, then they will be quite easy, because you just need to take away this er form and you put a accent aigu instead. Phonetically, it's quite easy because it's exactly the same thing. Parler will become parler. Regarder will become regarder. And even this tricky verb aller, to go, remember you don't conjugate that like the verbs from the first group, but even this one, when it comes to this participe passé form, then it's quite easy because it goes like aller. Okay? Parler, parler, regarder, regarder, aller, aller. Alright, so the second group of regular verbs, so ending with ER, remember we're not talking about all the verbs ending with ER, but they will be quite easy as well, because you just take away this ER thing and you just replace it with E. Okay, so choisir will become choisi, finir will become fini, unir will become uni, okay, etc., etc. After that, of course, we've got the tricky ones. So verbs from the third group. So we can make some subgroups, but then be careful. You should definitely learn them by heart, but if it helps. So les participes passés qui finissent avec U, that will end with U, for example. Connaître will become connu. Voir will become vu. Okay, and then in E as well. So partir will become parti. Rire will become ri, okay, and then in IT, écrire will become écrit, dire will become dit, and then in IS, mettre will become mis, and prendre will become pris. Okay, so connaître, to know, connu, voir, to see, vu, partir, to leave, parti, rire, to laugh, ri, écrire, to write, écrit, dire, to say, dit, mettre, to put, mis, prendre, to take, pris. Okay? A few examples now, or I will conjugate the verb parler at the passé antérieur form, and you will get j'eus parlé, tu eus parlé, il eut parlé, elle eut parlé, on eut parlé, nous eûmes parlé, vous eûtes parlé, ils eurent parlé, elles eurent parlé. Okay, so you can see that we've got our participe passé that will end with E. Okay? For a good reason, because remember that when we use être, then something will happen, like for all the compound tenses in French, When we put être, then it means that at the end of your participe passé here, you will have to put whether the feminine or the plural form if needed. Of course, in that case, you get elle, so it's the feminine singular, so you should add this e at the end for the feminine singular. Then in that case, you get the plural, masculine plural, then you should put s for the masculine plural. And here you get the feminine plural, and you should add this e and s for the feminine plural. Okay, keep in mind that, well, it's actually quite easy because phonetically they are the same, all right? But then you should add this final e for the feminine, final s for the plural, and final es for the feminine plural. And it goes like that. Il fut allé, elle fut allée, ils furent allés, elles furent allées. Okay, so let's see now all the forms. Je fus allé, tu fus allé, il fut allé, elle fut allée, nous fûmes allés, vous fûtes allés, ils furent allés, elles furent allées. So I will make now the liaison because I know that some of you want me to make the liaison all the time. Je fus allé, tu fus allé, il fut allé, elle fut allée, nous fûmes allés, vous fûtes allés, ils furent allés, elles furent allées. Okay, so remember that you put e when needed for the feminine form, you put s when needed for the plural form, and then es for the feminine plural form. Okay? So keep in mind that le passé antérieur, one more time, you get avoir conjugated at the passé simple. Then you will have your participe passé form and you will get this passé antérieur form. In some cases, as we saw, we'll use être, same thing at the passé simple. Then your participe passé and it will give you le passé antérieur. Et voilà, have a great day, au revoir et à bientôt. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, leçon S. And in this lesson, we'll see les verbes en IR du troisième groupe. So keep in mind that in French, we've got three groups of verbs, and then the third one, the troisième groupe, is quite irregular, and especially we can find some verbs ending with IR, okay, that don't belong to the second group of regular verbs, but they belong to this third group. So we will see them, okay, because someone wanted me to list them. So of course, it's always a pleasure to please you. So let's see now how they go. And keep in mind that all the verbs en IR don't belong to the second group, because many people tend to think that all the IR verbs will be regular and they belong to the second group, and it's not the case, unfortunately, so we will see them right now. Tenir, s'abstenir, appartenir, contenir, détenir, entretenir, maintenir, obtenir, retenir, soutenir. Okay, so one more time. Tenir, s'abstenir, appartenir, contenir, détenir, entretenir, maintenir, obtenir, retenir, soutenir. Venir, advenir, circonvenir, contrevenir, convenir, devenir, disconvenir, intervenir, parvenir, prévenir. Okay, so let's read them one more time. Venir, advenir, circonvenir, contrevenir, convenir, devenir, disconvenir, intervenir, parvenir, prévenir. Provenir, redevenir, revenir, se souvenir, subvenir, survenir, acquérir, conquérir, s'enquérir, reconquérir. Okay, so one more time. Provenir, redevenir, revenir, se souvenir, subvenir, survenir, acquérir, conquérir, s'enquérir, reconquérir. Requérir, sentir, consentir, pressentir, ressentir, mentir, démentir, partir, repartir, se repentir. And one more time. Requérir, sentir, consentir, pressentir, ressentir, mentir, démentir, partir, repartir, se repentir. Sortir, ressortir, vêtir, dévêtir, revêtir, ouvrir, couvrir, découvrir, redécouvrir, recouvrir. So one more time. Sortir, ressortir, vêtir, dévêtir, revêtir, ouvrir, couvrir, découvrir, redécouvrir, recouvrir. Entrouvrir, rouvrir, offrir, souffrir, cueillir, accueillir, recueillir, assaillir, défaillir, faillir. Entrouvrir, rouvrir, offrir, souffrir, cueillir, accueillir, recueillir, assaillir, défaillir, faillir. Bouillir, dormir, endormir, s'endormir, rendormir, se rendormir, courir, accourir, concourir, discourir. So one more time. Bouillir, dormir, endormir, s'endormir, rendormir, se rendormir, courir, accourir, concourir, discourir. Encourir, parcourir, recourir, secourir, mourir, servir, desservir, resservir, fuir, s'enfuir. So one more time. Encourir, parcourir, recourir, secourir, mourir, servir, desservir, resservir, fuir, s'enfuir. And this is it. Quite many verbs I know, but I hope you will learn them by heart, of course. Au revoir et à bientôt. Have a great day. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 17, Leçon T. And in this lesson, we'll see together les verbes en oir, so from the third group, of course, so les verbes en oir, en oir. Okay, so let's start now. Recevoir, apercevoir, concevoir, décevoir, percevoir, voir, entrevoir, prévoir, revoir, pourvoir. Okay, so one more time. Recevoir, apercevoir, concevoir, décevoir, percevoir, voir, entrevoir, prévoir, revoir, pourvoir. Savoir, devoir, pouvoir, mouvoir, émouvoir, promouvoir, pleuvoir, repleuvoir, falloir, valoir. Okay, so let's repeat them. Savoir, devoir, pouvoir, mouvoir, émouvoir, promouvoir, sorry, it doesn't look so nice, but then promouvoir, pleuvoir, repleuvoir, falloir, valoir. Équivaloir, prévaloir, revaloir, vouloir, asseoir, rasseoir, soir, sursoir, choir, déchoir. So let's repeat them. Équivaloir, prévaloir, revaloir, vouloir, asseoir, rasseoir, soir, sursoir, choir, déchoir. And that's it. So if you want more videos, then this is the channel. Of course, you can like me on Facebook. I will be so happy. I'm also on SoundCloud, so you can check it. And then if you want some apps, PDFs, audio, flashcards, quite many things, all the things I've been doing so far, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Au revoir et à bientôt.